A great way to start, isn't it, church? Good morning, church. A very warm welcome to the parish church this morning for this wonderful occasion, Reverend Kate's first Mass. A great joy to have in church, a great joy to share online. We have two new priests with us today, so it's a great joy to have Sharon, Reverend Sharon, with us as well from Derwent Oak, part of our fellowship. Where we are worshipping together. Sharon's first Eucharist, you're not calling it, what are you calling it? First Eucharist, is it 18th of July, is that right, Sharon? So Sharon's first is the 18th of July, and more details are in the news sheet about that, which you can get on the website. You just click on the front page of the website and the news sheet is there. The notices for our service this morning. Kate is going to bring everybody Holy Communion this morning, so communion will take a little bit longer than normal. She's going to come around, and I ask you to stay in your seats and again leave your mask on until Kate has moved on to the next person. After the service today, Kate is going to be, it's traditional that a new priest gives a personal blessing. And so Kate will be in the garden, and if you want to come forward for a personal blessing, please do so. Maintain social distancing, and Kate will be doing that after the service. It has been a long journey that Kate has been on to get to this point, and Kate has dealt with more than most ordinands do. So it is a huge privilege and a huge joy to have Kate celebrate with us this morning. So we'll now keep a time of silence. And let us pray for Kate and for Sharon.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Today, we hear the story of a courageous woman of faith who defied convention to reach out to Jesus, trusting that in him alone she would be made whole. So let us call to mind our fragility and our need of God's forgiveness. May the God of all love and power forgive and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you through the Holy Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God of inclusive love, who calls us each by name, we thank you for the woman who stood out of the crowd to connect with you. May the flowing power of Christ bring healing and acceptance to the rejected and abused. Through Jesus Christ, giver of life.
Reading from the Book of Psalms. Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. The faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. If you say, "The Lord is my refuge," and you make the Most High your dwelling, no harm will overtake you. No disaster will come near your tent. For He will command His angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. You will tread on the lion and the cobra. You will trample the great lion and the serpent. Because she loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue her. I will protect her, for she acknowledges my name. She will call upon me, and I will answer her. I will be with her in her trouble. I will deliver her and honor her. With long life will I satisfy her and show her my salvation. For the word of God in Scripture, for the word of God among us, for the word of God within us, thanks be to God.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. When Jesus had crossed again in the boat to the other side, a great crowd gathered around him, and he was by the lake. Then one of the leaders of the synagogue, named Jairus, came, and when he saw him, fell at his feet and begged him repeatedly, "My little daughter is at the point of death. Come and lay your hands on her, so that she may be well and live." So he went with him, and a large crowd followed him and pressed in on him. Now there was a woman who had been suffering from hemorrhages for 12 years. She had endured much under many physicians and had spent all that she had, and she was no better, but rather grew worse. She'd heard about Jesus and came up behind him in the crowd and touched his cloak. For she said, "If I but touch his clothes, I will be made well." Immediately her hemorrhage stopped, and she felt in her body that she was healed of her disease. Immediately, aware that power had gone forth from him, Jesus turned about in the crowd and said, "Who touched my clothes?" And his disciples said to him, "You see the crowd pressing in on you. How can you say, 'Who touched me?'" But Jesus looked all around to see who had done it. And the woman, knowing what had happened to her, came in fear and trembling, fell down before him, and told him the whole truth. Then he said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your disease." While he was still speaking, some people came from the leader's house to say, "Your daughter is dead. Why trouble the teacher any further?" But overhearing what they said, Jesus said to the leader of the synagogue, "Do not fear. Only believe." He allowed no one to follow him except Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. When they came to the house of the leader of the synagogue, he saw a commotion, people weeping and wailing loudly. When he entered, he said to them, "Why do you make a commotion and weep? The child is not dead, but sleeping." And they laughed at him. Then he put them all outside and took the child's father and mother and those who were with him, went in to where the child was. Then he took her by the hand and he said to her, "Talitha kum," which means, "Little girl, get up." And immediately the girl got up and began to walk about. She was 12 years of age. At this, they were overcome with amazement. Jesus strictly ordered them that no one else should know this, and he told them to give her something to eat. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Thank you. May I speak in the name of our ever-loving God. Amen. Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your disease. Let's just pause and take in those incredible words of Jesus, just for a moment. Last week, Father Julian spoke of how sometimes the lectionary fits the occasion perfectly. Today is one of those occasions. And today I'm just focusing on the story of an anonymous woman who has been bleeding for 12 years. She's an outcast, deemed unclean by the purity laws of the time. Probably jaundiced, certainly anemic, debilitated. She's forgotten what it feels like to be well. She's probably bewildered and afraid, and her actions would be considered outrageous, approaching a man without consent in the middle of the day when she's supposed to be behind closed doors. But she's out of money and options, except for one. Inching along the floor, in the dust, desperate to grasp the hem of Jesus' cloak, without knowing what the outcome would be. Today, we call her condition a bleeding disorder. I know her exhaustion and discomfort, her bewilderment. I once spent everything I had to get my own bleeding disorder recognised. So I've always felt an affinity with this woman and drawn inspiration from her courage in stepping out from the crowd. Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your disease. Some of you may know that I have also had cancer. And when I received my diagnosis, because of the bleeding disorder, conventional treatment was too risky. And I was forced to come to terms with the fact that I was possibly facing a lifespan of months rather than the years I'd taken for granted. And in facing that, it was this gospel story, this sacred text, that I returned to. What could I learn from this amazing woman? She wanted more to life than to be identified only through illness and alienation. She trusted that who she would be in the future had not yet been revealed. And that future was in God's hands, no one else's. She could not have known what the outcome would be as she reached out to Jesus. But perhaps she accepted that whatever form her healing took, however long she had, everything would be okay. All she knew was without Christ, there was no meaning, no life. I like to think that she also knew her scriptures and might have found hope in the words of Psalm 91 that Molly read to us so beautifully, especially those closing verses. She will call upon me and I will answer her. During my illness, I took the liberty of crossing all the masculine language out in my Bible at the end of that psalm and replacing it with the feminine. And praying those words, saying them every day, and believing them, whatever the outcome. We often pray for healing, but that healing does not always come in the way we might want it to. Sometimes healing is simply not allowing fear to dominate your life. Sometimes it looks like acceptance, knowing you are loved just as you are in all your fragility as you show up. Sometimes it might be the healing of forgiveness, whether that's forgiving others, yourself, or both. The healing I sought was inner peace, freedom from the fear of my own suddenly very, very visible mortality, to walk in the light of resurrection hope and truly know that death is still life in another form. Like the woman in our gospel reading, I was out of options. The only choice I had was to surrender to God. Just over 2 weeks ago, I reached my 5-year cancer anniversary. But there is no remission. Those 5 years have gone so quickly, all by God's grace. And I have strived to live one day at a time in the abundance of love which Christ promises every single one of us. I don't always succeed. Some days I'm really rubbish. And in those times, I go back to this gospel, those words, to Psalm 91. Another 5 months, another 5 years, another 5 weeks, they're not guaranteed, and that is okay. It's all in God's hands. This passage, especially this passage, has taught me that in our times of suffering, loss, despair, all we can do is to surrender to God, the source of all being, the one for whom we exist, as we'll say today in our liturgy. Without cancer, without a volatile bleeding disorder, I would not have thrown myself at God's feet. I would not have prayed those words from today's gospel. I would not still, this morning, this evening, every day, be clinging onto the hem of Christ's cloak. Without that time, without learning that total surrender, I would not be standing here today, newly priested alongside Reverend Sharon. And I can hardly believe those words as I say them. And it is humbling and a privilege to be here. And it is all grace. Thank you. But friends, this is not just my story. This is our story. This woman stands for all of us who feel out of hope and out of options. Through our sacred wounds, transformation, healing can happen. Daughter, son, child of God, your faith has made you well. In a few moments, we'll hear the choir sing of the vast, unfathomable, eternal presence of God, whose time is now and evermore, whose place is everywhere. If we believe that, there is nothing to fear. Our identity is in Christ's resurrection, in life, never in death. We are liberated. We have eternal hope. We go in peace and we are healed. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Thank you.
So let us affirm together our common faith in Jesus Christ. Do you believe and trust in God the Creator, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist?
I believe.
Do you believe and trust in God's Son, Jesus Christ, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again? Do you believe and trust in God's Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
I believe
and trust in God. This is the faith of the church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
In our gospel, Jesus reveals the wideness of God's tender mercy for all who come to him for help. Let us, inspired by the Spirit, offer our prayers in union with Jesus to God, the Father of love and mercy. If you're following our service online, please add your own prayers on screen if you would like to. Creator, redeeming and sustaining God, hear our prayer for all, like Jairus in our gospel, who cry out to you desperately for help for themselves or those they love. For all, like the anonymous woman in our gospel, who have suffered for years with chronic ill health or other deep distress. For all who, despite hurts, fears, and disappointments, like you, like her, reach out to you with faith and courage, waiting in trust and hope for your grace in their lives. God of love, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For those whose lives have been overwhelmed by the COVID pandemic in this country and around the world, by accidents, natural disasters, or the folly or cruelty of their fellow men and women. God of love, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For all the nations of the world and their leaders, for our own nation, our Queen, our Prime Minister and government and Parliament, and all who serve us in public life. For all in our world who long for just and compassionate government and a home with peace and security, and the basic resources of life for themselves and their families. God of love, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For your church in every place, called to bear joyful witness to your love for the earth and every living soul on it, in this place, for Libby, our bishop, for the community of this church and the other Christian communities in our fellowship, for those ordained this weekend, and today especially with joy and great thanksgiving, for Sharon, ordained priest, to serve in Derwent Oak, and for Kate, ordained priest, to serve here, celebrating her first Mass today. May your grace, joy, and peace be upon them, and may they know here the kind and loving support of us all. God of love, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For those in our parish who are vulnerable, sick, or troubled in their circumstances, and all for whom we have been asked to pray. God of love, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For those who are coming to the end of their lives, that they may know your comfort and peace at the last. For those who have died, that they may see and receive your mercy and find their rest and everlasting joy in you. For those who mourn the loss of those they love, may they know your abiding comfort and peace. God of love, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For all whom we love, near and far away, for our families and friends, and all who enrich our lives with their love. And lastly, for ourselves, may our lives be always open to receive and to share your mercy and unconditional love. Commend these prayers, those written on the screen, and the prayers of our hearts to our Blessed Mother, who gave an unqualified yes to your gift of love. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Just keep silent for a moment while we wait for the children to come back into church. Share the peace. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. My friends, the peace of the risen Christ be always with you. And let's share each other an appropriate sign of peace.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks
and praise. Eternal God, in the abundance of your love, you have caused all things to be. From dust and spirit, you've woven our humanity. In all our wanderings, you never cease to call us to fullness of life. You shared your name with our mothers and fathers, Sarah and Abraham, who left their home and became a blessing to all nations. Moses and Miriam, who went through sea and wilderness to the place of revelation. Deborah and Samson, who gave hope and justice to a people ruled by fear. Ruth and Jonah, who went to foreign soil and found God who loves the stranger. From our ancestors in faith came Jesus, the Son of promise, to fulfill the law, embody your love, and draw all people to himself. He accepted death to break its fearful hold. He was raised to life to share it in abundance. He comes to break the bread and pour the wine of hope. Therefore, with all the people whose story you have shaped, with women and men of faith in every part of the world, we glory in your generous love and sing in praise of you. We ask that your Holy Spirit will fall upon us and upon these gifts, that these fragile earthly things may be to us the body and blood of our Lord and brother Jesus Christ, who on the night that he was betrayed, gathered with his faltering friends for a meal that tasted of freedom. Calling them to his table, he took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and said, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it to remember me." As on that night, so here and now, he offers himself in touch and taste beyond all words can hold. Mm-hmm. Therefore, in our eating and drinking, we are filled with the life-giving presence of Christ. We proclaim him as creation's host, transforming poverty into plenty in the reckless generosity of love. Inspire us with the hope that one day, death and greed will be no more, and people without number will come from east and west, north and south, to share the kingdom meal. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, God of all blessing, forever and ever. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. We are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. If you are joining us online, I hope you have your own bread and wine or food and drink, gathered here in church and online. Receive what you are, the body of Christ.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Eternal God, whose time is now and evermore, you have fed us at the table of life and hope. Teach us the ways of gentleness and peace, that all the world may come to know your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Well, Kate, I think we can safely say you've certainly celebrated a traditional Spondon Eucharist this morning in every way. Well done. It is a joy to have you. There is nothing quite like keeping going when that happens. So all our prayers are with Norman. I think Reverend Fran is taking him to the hospital. And thanks to Kate and thanks to everyone who helped and Charlotte and everyone who helped. Just want to say a few words of, it's not welcome, Kate, but I think a big round of applause for our lovely Kate. And we do have, I think we've got some gifts from the kids. I think, who's got the stuff from the kids? Okay, so Sharon, can you come forward as well? Could you, if we kind of stand, can we come and stand? Oh. Ellis made those himself. And Sharon. Some flowers for Sharon as well. That's wonderful. And a card from Children's Church. It's just such a joy to have you both in the fellowship and to have you as colleagues. It's just stunning. I can't really say anymore. Kate, we do have a little thing for you from the parish. It's traditional. The parish gets you something that's going to be really useful for your ministry, okay? And we could have got you something religious, but we thought some things are holier than that, really. So there we go. I might say it's not from Sainsbury's, but it didn't come in. So there's a little something to help the ministry go.
Well, that's tonight taking care of, anyway.
A little something to help you work with me, I think, is what that's about. But anyway, Kate, it's a joy. Let's stand. It's too heavy. Let's stand. Can I remind you, if you want a personal blessing from Kate, she will be in the garden afterwards to give personal blessings. If someone can't get out there that wants a personal blessing, just let me or let a ward know and Kate can come to you. But it is a great joy, Kate.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It is an honour. And an utter privilege. Thank you.
God be with you.
And also with you.
Christ, who has nourished us with himself, the living bread, make you one in praise and love, and raise you up at the last day. And the blessing of God, creator, redeemer, and sustainer, be among you and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
Thank you.